Alright, this is my new evaporator in action. The 2x6 pan. Just kind of stoked up here, so it's not quite a full boil. But it's getting there. I used a 265-gallon heating oil barrel. I cut the top off of it. Added a stove door. Got three 2-inch pipes in there. And the middle one is for a blower if I needed it to get a decent airflow through there. But I think it goes good enough. And then I put the other pipes on there so it wouldn't blow back. I could just cap those two off if needed. But right now they're just all three are air intakes. Matter of fact, I could have probably used a couple more. As you can see, it works better if I have the door cracked a bit. So anyway, I cut the top off of this. And I took about 27 inches of the top to add to the bottom, add to the length to receive the whole pan. The heating oil barrel is about 5 feet long, so I just needed this little extra. I took one end of that top, did the bottom, and then I cut the other end of the top a little short for the top of this. And I just welded them together. Welded a 6-inch outlet for the stove pipe. There you can see I have a 55-gallon drum. I was hoping to get a lot more sap than what I did. And then I'd be able to just slowly drip the sap in, have it warm up around the stove pipe, and then drip into the pan at the rate that it's evaporating. Maintain a boil and a constant level. So maybe next season, we'll have a better sap run. But for now, I'm just pouring it in about 3 gallons at a time. You can see I use some stove tape just to seal up and keep the heat right at the bottom of the pan. See the size of my firebox, it's about 3 feet. And I just put a steel plate in the middle, and then right at this level here is where I put a pan and then fire brick on top of that. And that way, just the fire exits on top of the fire brick and the bottom of the pan until it gets to here. That's, you know, not bad. That's got 3.5 inches of rock wall, and then another 2 inches of fire brick lining the whole firebox here. And obviously nothing on the front. So it's doing good. Doing well. I should be able to get at least 12 gallons an hour evaporated out of here. It means I can make a gallon of syrup just under 4 hours. So we'll have to do all the testing for that next year once we get a decent run. Alright, that's all I have. If you have any questions, just ask.